a hypertrophy day for legs, so try to keep the reps between 10 and 12. I started out with squats. I did 185, 205, 225, and another set of 225, all four sets of 10. Right now I'm squatting twice a week. On Tuesdays I'm squatting heavy. Heavy for me, I'm not very strong with the legs, but starting to actually really feel comfortable with squatting, so I'm very happy with my progress. I'm going to do a powerlifting meet in August, so God willing, I'll be killing it at that meet. Followed that up with a leg press machine. The gym we were working out wasn't super equipped. I prefer the hack squat. I get a lot out of that, so we jumped over to the leg press instead. I think I did a set with 4 plates, 6 plates, and then 2 sets with 7 plates. My last set I only got 8 reps. My endurance is pretty good right now, so I'm working on that. But. Felt pretty good, and then I jumped into supersetting. So I supersetted with calves and leg curls, 3 sets of each, and then I finished up supersetting with leg extensions on the machine and some dumbbell lunges. And by the time I got to my last set of dumbbell lunges, I was done. Currently, I just won my pro card in November of last year, and honestly, I was a little shocked. It was my first pro qualifier. I was kind of, you know, just trying to gauge where I was at in natural bodybuilding. I've been lifting for 16, 17 years, so I've got a pretty good base, and I hired Lane Norton to do my diet. And, you know, I followed some of the top natural pros and gotten a lot of advice from them. You know, I've been in touch with guys like Brian Whitaker and that, so. I feel like I have a pretty good touch. So after winning my pro card in November, the NGA Universe is a pro and amateur show, and I won my pro card there. And I got to stand next to the pros backstage, just kind of an eye opener, you know, when you're standing backstage with some seasoned pros. So I decided pretty much to take about a year and a half off to add some size, you know, so next time I step on stage, I'm not the same bodybuilder. So I went and watched Lane compete at Raw Unity in Tampa a few months ago, and I kind of got the powerlifting bug. I've never been strong, you know, what I would consider strong. Absolutely a horrible squatter. Deadlift, I've been working pretty hard at for the last couple of years, and I feel pretty decent. And, you know, I've been flat benching since I was 16 years old, like, you know, most kids do. I was all bench and curl back then, so. Gonna compete in August in a powerlifting meet, and I may do one other one by the end of the year. But I won't be stepping on the bodybuilding stage again until late 2011. Probably start my diet early summer, late spring, and do a couple shows in the fall, a couple IFPA pro shows and a couple NGA pro shows, and just see what falls in line at that time. You never know what life's going to bring you, but my biggest goal right now is just putting on some size, so when I get on stage, I look like I belong, you know, so I can at least want to place in the top five in my first pro show, you know. So, August 7th, powerlifting, late 2011, a couple pro shows, see where I stand, and I was fortunate, I just got picked up by Salvation, so I'm officially sponsored. When I was introduced to competitive bodybuilding a few years ago, I contacted Lane Norton, introduced me to Salvation products, and I've been using them for the last 3 years religiously. All my friends use them, my girlfriend uses them, everybody, you know, everyone that comes in contact with me knows my stance on Salvation, so I feel very fortunate. You know, Mark at Salvation is a great guy, Derek and Rob, it's just a great company. I really believe everything that they do for the sport, you know. I like that they create products selfishly that they themselves use. That really gives you a good indication of, you know, what you're getting, because they're all competitive bodybuilders and they all use their stuff, so it's an easy fit for me, and I'm looking forward to actually, you know, representing Salvation at others. So we'll go over my diet a little bit, just basic information. I eat, right now in the off season being, I'm not dieting for a show, but I still track my daily numbers so that I make sure I'm improving my numbers in the gym, putting up more weight. So I'm consuming six meals a day right now. I start at 7 a.m. My last meal is around 11 p.m. I eat every 4 hours. Most of my meals consist of, you know, 45 grams of protein, 30-40 grams of carbs, and a few grams of fat. I try to get, you know, at least 60-70 grams of fat a day. I spread that out pretty evenly. Pre and post workout, I'll bump my carbs up. You know, I'll have between 75 and 100 grams of carbs pre and post workout, just to really fuel the workout and fuel the recovery. I drink Extend between meals. So if I'm eating every 4 hours, in between there, I'll spike my insulin a little bit with some carbs, and I'll drink some Extend. And then I take the essential fatty acids by Salvation. I also use their brand new pre-workout supplement, Quake. I was a big fan of AcidCharge, and I've been using Quake for about a week now. I love it. So those are my staples. I also take a multivitamin, and I take creatine, you know, 5 grams of creatine a day. So pretty basic, and then, you know, my food choices. I cook all my meals. I ate a ton of chicken, a ton of eggs. My fridge is just chicken and eggs mostly. And I'll buy some steaks every now and then. I love rice and sweet potatoes. So I know people consider that diet food, but I really enjoy it. So those are pretty much my staples. You know, in the off season, I'll have a few cheats, if you want to call them that. I don't really call them cheats, but you know, I eat a little more freely. During contest prep, obviously, I cut down on that. Track everything to the calorie, but in the off season, my main goal is just staying healthy, but making sure I'm getting enough for my workouts and recovering properly.